Have you got any regrets in your career so far?
Can't say regrets. Yeah. I don't think you can live with regrets. I think you just gotta go into each day with enthusiasm and just do the best you can, really. If you live with regrets, you'll always, you'll end up making mistakes, so you're gonna make mistakes anyway, so it's no point living with regrets, I think.
If you had the choice, what international team would you play for?
Big question. With the World Cup coming up, I've been speaking to Nigeria. So my parents are Nigerian, so I can play for Nigeria. If I had a choice, I think I'd play for England, obviously because they're the better team. But Nigeria want me to play for them, so hopefully in the near future I can play for them and represent Nigeria, which I think will make my parents quite proud, seeing as they're from there. Yeah.
What GCSE grades did you get?
I think I've done quite well, you know. I don't know how. I got 7 A's and 3 B's, which is alright, isn't it, I think. So yeah, I've been happy. I used to miss a lot of school as well, playing for everything. I'd have days off and whatnot, but just studied really hard when it came to the tests. I managed to do okay with a bit of luck, so I was really happy.
What were your favourite subjects in school?
My favourite subjects were PE, obviously. Whenever you're doing football, if you've done anything else, I wouldn't like it. I like science as well. I'm a bit of a science geek, secretly, don't tell anyone. But I enjoyed the experiments and learning about the world. And I still do a bit of science in my spare time now, a bit of Open University. So yeah, I think I really did like science.
What were your best and worst moments at school?
Best and worst moments. Now and again, I used to get in a little bit of trouble. And playing football in school, I smashed one of the windows. I think it was just over there inside the quarry, so got into a bit of trouble for that. Spent a bit of time in detention, but as you say, it's just a learning curve. In school, I was just learning, trying to do the best I can. Sometimes I make mistakes, as I said, but again, no regrets. Best moment? Can't really say there's a best moment. We won a few trophies with the school team. I think in year, that's been in the last year, in year 11, we got to the final, won the cup, so that was really good. I love school, to be fair. I think Calderstones is a good school. I don't know if you agree. I think it's a good school.
Yeah.
I mean, I enjoyed my time there, so I think my whole 5 years there was really good. So can't really pick the best moment.
How old were you when you got signed for an academy?
I was 8 years old, playing Sunday League in Botanic Park. I don't know if any of you know where that is. Yeah, Picton Way, which you went. Yeah, right behind Matalan. I used to play in that car park when I was a kid. Played there maybe not even about 6 months. And then the Everton scouts came to see another player. And from them coming to see that player, I must have had a good game, scored a few goals. And they asked me to come along. Went for a week's trial and signed the same week. So obviously I was really happy. I supported Liverpool, but you know, sometimes you've got to make them sacrifices.
Did you ever think you'd be a professional footballer, and did you ever lose hope?
Trying to be funny there. Yeah, I did, to be fair. I mean, it was always my dream, and starting football so young, it was always one of my goals. Obviously, there's times you have a bit of doubt, and sometimes you're not doing as well as you thought you would have done. But like I said, you've got to keep working hard, you've got to train every day, try and do the right things to make yourself the best player you can be. That goes for anything you do, whether it's in school, at work. You're just trying to apply yourself and be the best you can be. You can't go far wrong, I think. So yeah, I did think I was going to be a professional footballer, and I'm glad I'm doing what I love.
If you had the chance, which team would you love to play for?
It's a tricky one. If I'm being honest, it would be Liverpool. You know, I'm a bit jealous of Joel there playing for the Reds, because as I said, I was a Liverpool supporter when I was a kid. But obviously I played for Everton for 10 years, so my loyalties kind of moved over to the blue side. But if I had the choice, I mean, playing for Liverpool this season when they're doing well, I think it would be amazing. So Liverpool would be a team that I'd love to play for.
Who are the best players you've played with and played against?
I've played with quite a few good players at Everton at the time. They had a good team. Around my age was Jack Rodwell. He's at Manchester City now, he's a good player. Arteta, he's at Arsenal. Quality Fellaini at United, and I'd say Steven Pienaar, who are top players. Played against Arsenal, Santi Cazorla.
Yeah.
Was frightening. Like, he was an alien. He wasn't a human being. He could just move so quick with both footed. So that was a tough test for me. He was a great player, definitely. Miss York, I'll tell you a few stories. I had a few moments, but I didn't try and be naughty or anything. I was just trying to be a good kid, but sometimes, you know, you make mistakes. I definitely learned from those mistakes, and I won't do them stupid things again. But I was a bit naughty now and again, but I think everyone's got a little naughty streak in them, but it's just about trying to behave and do the best you can.
What habits or activities did you have to give up to play football?
I mean, Joel will tell you, with football, from a young age, you're training most days. So when everyone else was going on into Green Bank Park and Smith Down Road, of a Friday night or a Saturday night, I'd always have a game in the morning. So I couldn't go. My dad would lock me up in the house, or I'd go for like an hour and then have to go back home. So stuff like that, like a few parties and stuff when I was a bit younger, I couldn't really go to. I try to eat as healthy as I can. I don't know what the school dinners are like these days. Are they any good? Better?
Yeah.
I don't think they were the best in my day. All smiley faces and chips every day, chip cookies. But I try to eat as healthy as I can. Obviously, don't smoke and don't really drink. So there are a few of the sacrifices that you have to make. But you know, I love what I do, so I'm willing to make those sacrifices, I guess.
Who's your role model out of football?
My dad's a big role model for me. I've seen him come to this country and study hard and work really hard to get what he's got, so he's a big role model for me. Outside of football, I'm into films a lot, so Denzel Washington is a big role model for me. A lot of my role models are in football, so it's hard to say. Nelson Mandela, who passed away recently, he was a role model. I read his book when I was in school, so he was a big role model for me, what he went through and what he achieved.
What's your usually doing outside of football?
Outside of football, you know, I just like chilling with friends and play a bit of FIFA now and again. Not the best, but you know, I'll still be talking to you. And I've started playing golf. Don't know if any of you tried golf. No, I wouldn't try it. It's so hard. I'm so bad at golf. But all the other lads do it, and I'm good, so I try and compete with them. But that's most of the time, it's downtime, just chilling, recovering from training, which is important. So I'm just at home chilling, really.
When did you start playing football?
As early as I can remember, I've been playing football. I'm still not sure if I've got talent. I just work hard and try and improve. I'll tell you one story. My dad used to beat me up. Not joking. I used to play football in my dad's shop, and he used to knock all the things over. So he used to lock up and go and get his car, and while he brought his car around, I'd get dead excited and be throwing the ball up and heading it all around the shop. And I took a big chest, and took a big body, scored top corner, and I've knocked the whole row of tomato sauce onto the floor. So I'm like, Dad, don't know what to do. I've took my jacket off, tried to clean the tomato sauce. Dad's coming raging, you're always playing football, you're not allowed to play football no more, I'm taking you off the team. Started crying, but managed to get back on side with him and got back up to the tannic and carried on playing. Luckily, or I wouldn't be where I am today. But yeah, a young age, I realised I was okay at football. Just playing in the park with friends, you know, I realised I was okay, decent.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you still keep friends that you had in school and in your old football teams and stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a few of the lads on there that I'm still really close to. A lot of them are still my best friends that I met in school. Try and keep those people around me to keep you level headed, or just to keep. Obviously, I live away from home, so it's hard to keep all the relationships with people that you grew up with, but I try to keep that close circle of friends that I've always had. Just I think they'll always be honest with you and they'll always tell you the truth. And I think that's important in life, in whatever you do, just to keep a good group of friends. You don't need loads of friends, you don't need everyone to be your mate, but as long as you can trust people and have a good circle of friends around you, I don't think you can go wrong.
How did you feel when you scored your first goal for Bedden?
I felt really happy. It was a bit of a relief for me because I hadn't really been playing early in the season, so I was a bit lacking confidence, a bit down. But it was just a relief. Scoring any goal anywhere is a good feeling. I think we won that game 7-1.
Yeah.
So it was awesome. Yeah. So it was really, it was a good win. The fans were loving it. I was loving it. So yeah, I really enjoyed it. Really enjoyed it.
What was it like dropping down from Everton, who were like a Premiership team, to, you know, the lower divisions? How did that make you feel?
19, I decided to leave Everton. I wasn't playing, I was in the reserve teams and wasn't really getting a chance in the first team. Played one game but wasn't really getting a chance. So I decided to leave and go somewhere where I could play games. It was a big move for me. It was like Liverpool's here. I went to a team south of London, which is miles apart, didn't really know no one there, so it was a big step. And to be honest, I was feeling scared, to be honest. Obviously Everton's a big club, you got good facilities, you know, you get given good food after training, you know, the pitches are nice. Went to this team and the pitches were terrible. There was 20 lads waiting for one shower. There was no food after training. My other gone, I was thinking, oh, am I going to be able to cope with this? But obviously, I was given a chance to prove myself and play every week, play in front of crowds, play with men every week, playing for 3 points. Because in the reserve team, the games, you know, the important games, but they're not really important. You're not really playing for anything. At Crawley, every week, it was a battle. You were playing for 3 points. You had to win. If you didn't win, you're going to lose your job. If you won, everything was okay.
Yeah.
So having that on the line, I think, makes you a better player and just makes you work that bit harder to get back to the clubs where maybe life's a bit better, where there's food and where there's showers.
Were you the best player in your year at school?
Was I the best player there?
I said there was quite a few, wasn't there? There was you, there was Jack Booth, who was good at the time, Joshua Corley, you were up there. I think you were the most consistent, and I think consistency is important in football, isn't it?
Yeah. In my year, there was a few good players, to be honest. Jack Booth, Josh McCauley, just mentioned the name, James Henry. There's a few lads who were playing for teams. We had a good school team. To be fair, looking back, it was more than a few. There was good... good 7-8 players.
It was good core players.
Top players, yeah. We've all gone. I think that helped me, because I'd always want to try and be the best. So I just try and work that bit harder to make sure I was the best player. A lot of them have gone on to do the different things. But yeah, there was quite a few good players in our year. But I take the title, definitely. Take the belt.
Which manager have you learned the most from in your career?
Question. I think different managers have taught me different things. At Everton, it was a lot about making yourself a better player, so it was a lot of technical work. When I went to Crawley, if you ever meet this guy, Steve Evans, you don't want to meet him. If you make any mistakes, say the wrong thing, do the wrong thing, he's on your back, he's looking to kill you. So I learned to conduct myself, like not being afraid, but still do what I wanted to do, knowing that he didn't want me to do it, if you know what I mean. So I think that builds your character, builds your courage. I was signed to Reading by a guy called Brian McDermott, and he was just a great guy, just filled with loads of confidence. And now our manager is Nigel Atkins, and he's a good coach, like football wise. So in all four managers I mentioned there, I've got a real circle of technical and character building and like coaching there in the game. So I've been lucky to have good coaches, I guess. Yeah. Any more video? Wow, no. Look at the bling bling in me. I still haven't got them pictures, you know.
Haven't you?
No, neither.
What about the calendar?
The calendar?
You can't make the
calendar.
I should have brought that
over. The one that we sold to all the girls in the year, you and all the lads. Don't you remember it?
Make money for the prom.
Oh, yeah. Okay, when we were fundraising for the prom. Yeah. What was in the calendar, though? Was it?
Just photos you used.
It was okay though, clothes on.
Yeah.
So it's the way you were looking at me, you think I've done. Have our clothes on, mostly. Yeah, good days.
Did the girls used to like
you? The girls used to like me?
I told them anyway, you kissed football in the game. You wasn't interested.
Yeah, I wasn't interested in the girls. We used to sleep in my football. Yeah.
Do you think Reading could get promoted into the Prem this season?
Yeah, we should do. I mean, we're in the playoff position now. We're sick in the last playoff position, so we're hanging on a little bit. But it's in our hands. I mean, we've got more points than the teams below us, so if we win more games than them, we should get promoted, get back to the Premier League. Holy Land.
Would you ever play football abroad if you got a chance?
I mean, I've got a few friends who've gone to America.
Yeah.
A lad who was here, Jack Booth, went to school there. He's just gone to the States to do a bit of coaching, I think. I know a few lads have gone to like Qatar and the Middle East, and a few have gone to Thailand. So, I mean, it's sort of all them countries, the football's getting better and it's getting bigger, and there's a lot of people over there. The numbers of people who go to watch the football games is so many. So I think in coming years, them places will get bigger, so maybe it's something that I would do. Definitely.
Who was your inspiration when you was young to like be successful?
As a kid, I loved Steven Gerrard. I still love him today. I was watching the Liverpool game yesterday, and I still get goosebumps watching Steven Gerrard. I don't know what it is. Just the fact that he was from Liverpool, came up the same way I did, playing for his local team. And it's gone on to do so well. I think stories like that always inspire you, especially when it's close to home and you can relate to it. So watching him as a kid, I read his book, used to watch everything he'd done when he played for Liverpool. Actually, I went to the beach with a few friends and like tried to sneak into his house when I was a kid, tried to get a look at what he was living like. So I guess he's one of the guys who really inspired me growing up, definitely.
PlayStation or
what do you play? We can't be friends, mate. It's all about PlayStation, surely. What? Xbox pads like this?
No, the pads too short on PlayStation.
Oh, the pads perfect. Proper players.
Well, I like that phone, that.
Stick to the Xbox then.
Do you have
an ultimate no, don't, to be fair. I don't really do that. I don't think. I just stick to like going online and just beating people 3, 4, 5 mil. That's what I stick to, really.
Who would you say is the best player at Reading now?
Yeah, best player at Reading.
I'd say the fun, Jimmy.
Would you?
Yeah.
He scores a lot of goals, doesn't he?
Yeah.
I'll tell you who's good, Gareth McCleary. Winger.
No, I don't know him.
He's one to watch, he's a good player. Alfie's good. Scores a lot of goals, little fox in the box. Yeah, he's a really good player. He's from not too far, he's from Manchester. So I get on with Alfie. We're the Northern boys in the team. So we all try and stick together. Yeah, Alfie's a really good player, to be honest. Yeah.
Who'd you
What?
How did you feel when you set up?
First game. I don't know if you've I don't know if you've seen it, it's a bit jammy, isn't it? But I meant it. Obviously meant it, just superior skill, do you know what I mean? Nah, complete fluke. I've gone to score. In the end I'm screaming, Gerard! And I've absolutely miss hit it, but it's felt it, I'll feel he's put it away. That was my first game. That was at St James Park, Newcastle. Yeah. Massive crowd, that's 60,000. Like you see the stadium, the stand is so high, being it's like, yeah, it was the pull there, top lad. Yeah, the stadium's quality in it. So to play there was, for my first game, was mad, it's proper exciting. Oh, it's so high, the away fans, isn't it? So high.
Which teams would you like to play against?
I'd like to play against. A Real Madrid or Barcelona, like a foreign team, hopefully in the Champions League one day, you never know. I think at the minute they're the best teams, aren't they? Real Madrid, yeah. Barcelona got the best players, so to play against them, test yourself against them players, I think it'll be really good. Really enjoy it.
I think that's a win or
I leave that up to you to decide. I don't know what I'd be like if Messi running at me, I tell you that. I have to try and keep my leg close so he doesn't make me. But yeah, I mean, that'll just be a good experience, I guess, to play against the top players like that.
Who was the player that you most want to play with?
Most want to play with?
Yeah.
You might be a bit surprised by this, but it'll probably be like a Xabi or an Iniesta. Not a Ronaldo or a Messi, because I just think, because I'm a midfielder, I can appreciate what they do, like, quite a lot. So obviously I'd love to play with Steven Gerrard, but I think I'd be a bit nervous playing next to him because he's my idol. So any midfielder like Iniesta or Xavi, I don't know if you know them players, I'd love to play with because I can appreciate what they do being a midfielder myself. Any more questions?
Did you play in the Millwall Cup?
Yeah, to be fair, played in it?
Yeah, we got beaten in the semis.
Oh, no, man.
Yeah.
Sucks. Yeah, played in the Milk Cup. Played in it twice. 1 year got to the semis. Beat by a Spanish team. I think La Coruña. Deportivo La Coruña. And the whole year we done really bad. Got knocked out on the group stage. I think I cried. But yeah, good experience. I mean, with Everton, we played on lots of tours. We go all over the world. We go Belgium, Italy, Spain, Germany, playing all of the teams, which is so sick. Like, I get to miss 2 weeks of school, go off and play all over the world. So I really, really enjoyed it. Yeah, it's a good experience.
Playing against like any of the best youngsters? Like...
I'm trying to think. Played against, no, but I don't know, Bojan.
Yeah.
He used to play for Barcelona. He was a joke. He was unbelievable. So quick. I'm trying to think who else. Holtby at Tottenham. Played against him when he was young.
Was he good though?
Yeah, he was decent. He came on trial to Everton after we played him and he never got in. He was there for 2 weeks and didn't get signed. And now look at him, he's playing for Tottenham, isn't he? So, you know, you can't live with no regrets, just go. You never know where you can end up, do you know what I mean?
What's the most embarrassing moment in football?
When I was about your age, I used to ball boy at the Everton games. And Everton are losing 1-0 to Charlton, I think it was, at home. So all the fans are going crazy, all booing, getting on the referee, getting on the players. And the ball's coming out to where I am. And I'm obviously trying to get the ball quick so Evan can get back in the game. And I've like run on the pitch.
And I've seen that on YouTube. The ball was still on the pitch and
he
picked it up.
No one really knows about it because I try and keep it under wraps.
I've seen that on YouTube. He's been on the pitch and
picked the ball. Yeah. All I've done was throw back to our player thinking like everything was going to be okay. Didn't realise I was on the pitch. And then the fans go, what are you doing there? I'll turn around and in my head I'm crying like
We've got Everton players, what are you doing there? One of the Charlton players, like Tash on the head, he's happy because they've got a free kick in our half. So he's like giving me a little pat on the head, a little ironic pat. I just wanted to grant it, you know, I just wanted to get out of there, get my stool up and go. And my head has gone out and finished. I didn't go back, I didn't ball away again because I was scared to go back to the now for like 2 weeks. But I went back about 2 weeks later with my coke and with my hat on, tried to like blend in. But yeah, that was so embarrassing. Then there was another time, same situation, same year, I think. Evan played Liverpool, Lee Carsley scored, we won 1-0.
Yeah.
And I've managed to get him like a photo of like the team celebrating, because I just ran on the pitch after they scored. That wasn't embarrassing, I just thought that was sick. Like, well, I was happy with that. But yeah, a few embarrassing moments here and there, which I won't go into too much detail about, but yeah, just got to move on. No regrets.
How did you feel when Everton offered you a pro contract?
I was buzzing. Obviously, being there so long, I seen a lot of lads leave who were good players. So to actually get given a pro and given your first bite at like being a professional and it being in a contract that you are a professional footballer, that was something special for me. I was over the moon with that. Yeah.
How important do you think attitude is in regard to talent with football?
Yeah, there's a saying, I think it says, it's hard work beats talent if talent doesn't work hard. So you can be as talented as you want, you can be the best footballer, but if you don't want to practice and don't want to look after yourself and don't want to train hard and want to walk around and not really be enthusiastic, but you're not going to be the best player.
You don't cut it off 6 in the morning and go around Sefton Park with him.
Who's that? That you?
Yeah.
Guilty?
Yeah.
I've been around for Sefton Park a good few times, but they do you good. Not sure about the half 6 though. Who's that? Yeah, I was like that to be fair. Just go around there and beat them, then you won't want to take it anymore.
We've just been the worst ref.
Worst ref? There's a period when I was at Crawley where I got sent off like 3 times in the space of 2 weeks, so stupid. Live on Sky Sports. So whoever he was, he had a bald head. If I find him, there's problem now, so. But he was, yeah, I don't think he liked me very much. I don't think he liked me at all, to be honest. But yeah, there's a period where I did have a few red cards. I'm not a dirty player, but I do like to make a challenge, and I guess if you miss time challenges these days, you get sent off. But I took it like a man, said sorry, walked off. Early bath, cried in the change room.
Have you ever injured any players?
To be fair. It's a hard one for me because I'm not a dirty player. And it was early on in the game, I was just trying to make a challenge, went for the ball. And I've heard like a bad noise. Got up, thinking nothing of it, and the rest straight away give me a red card. And I'm arguing with the ref, thinking, why is he giving me a red card? But then I had a look down at the injured player, and he was in a bad way. Like, he was squirming, and his leg looked a bit quite messed up. He actually broke his leg in two places. He's back playing now, but he was out of play for a year and a half, maybe just over a year. So that was hard to deal with for me, because if it was me in that situation, I'd have been angry, upset, frustrated. So I went to see the lad a few times while he was in hospital when he got his operation. There's nothing you can really say in a situation like that, but just taught me a lesson, I guess, I'm not going to change because they're going to make tackles, but I guess just try and be careful, I guess.
Did you ever play for Liverpool
school, please? I did. Not for long. I don't know, I just didn't like it. I don't know what it was, maybe because I was so used to Everton and a certain way of doing things, and it was a bit different. And again, I was young, so I was just learning, and I couldn't really cope with them. Not necessarily training every day, just the different characters and the different people that. Because I was training with Everton every day, and I think it was one time a week I'd go to Liverpool. And as I said, that's maybe one regret I'd have. But I think it was because I was young, I couldn't really integrate with the other lads as well as I did the Evan players. So maybe that's one regret I've got, where I could have done better as a person, just been more outgoing and spoke to everyone. I was just sitting sat in the corner, didn't really talk to anyone, do you know what I mean? And that affected my football there. But that's one thing maybe I'd go back and do a bit better if I had a chance.
Are there any now professionals who are playing for the schoolboys
right now? That's a hard question. I think there's a few playing in the lower leagues, League 2, League 1s. I'm trying to think, it's got to be. There's one lad who played for Liverpool as well, who had a bad injury to be fair. He was a top lad, I'm Sean Hyder, I don't know if you heard of him. Sean Hyder, no one's speaking. He was unbelievable, but he ended up in a car crash and he injured his knees quite bad, so he wasn't able to play again. But he was a top player. He played for the school boys.
A lot of kids look up to you as a role model. How does that make you feel? And what advice would you give to any young people? Whether it's football or outside football,
yeah.
General advice.
I'm an ambassador for social inclusion at Reading, so I do speak to a lot of young players and a lot of young people. The advice I give to anyone trying to do anything in life is just work hard, be confident, be an individual as well. Don't be afraid to be different from everybody else. In school, I think a lot of people try to fit in as much as they can. But if you're different in any way, embrace it. Just who cares, you know what I mean? Just be the best person you can be. Apply yourself, be enthusiastic, and just try to enjoy whatever you do. That's the biggest advice I give to anyone.
What's the best moment you've seen in football?
Best moment I've seen? What do you mean, seen?
Like, not you, but like...
Oh, best moment I've seen. Steven Gerrard again, Champions League. 3-0 down, half time, 3-3 all. What was that?
Getting 3-0 first half, came back.
Decent. That's nice for that. Who's the play? Who's the play?
Winston,
yeah. Decent. You know Callum McManaman? Plays for Wigan?
Yeah. Winger?
He went to Winston, yeah. Played him a few times.
Liverpool, right?
Yeah. He was in my youth team for a long time. He got let go by when I didn't even get a youth contract. So he was let go at like 15. And he was unbelievable, but he was just a bit small. But obviously he didn't let that affect him, did he? He's gone to Wigan and now he's to say Liverpool, but what about him?
Yeah.
There you go. So whatever knockbacks you get, just get back up and go again. You never know where you could end up.
What's the best match you've played in?
Best match I've played in? Best match. Obviously I was at Everton for 10 years and left Everton, and within a year I was signed for Reading and I was playing there at Goodison again in front of David Moyes. Like, I always resented him because he let me go. But to be back there so quick and prove him wrong that I was a decent player and I could play at that level meant a lot to me, and all my family was in the crowd. So to go back to Goodison, I think that was...
Did you have a good game as well?
Yeah, I played alright. We got beat. But I think we're lucky, like Fellaini scored a stupid header. But to go back there so soon after being let go, and like all the players who were there when I was still there, you know, that was a big moment for me. That meant a lot, gave me a lot of confidence going into the future.
What's the
same as
your best quality?
Best quality, I think I'm a good passer. I think I am. And I can read the game a bit, so just move the ball quickly, pass, got good energy. I can nick a goal now and again. Well, I used to be able to, but for some reason I haven't scored him. When I scored that one goal, I used to score quite a few. But just passing and keeping the ball moving. Which one your best quality is?
Well,
I'm
centre-back.
Centre-back.
Yeah.
Good defender.
What's the
English
Cup
that
you've
ever won as a kid? English Cup. There's a few tournaments that we won at Everton, growing up, like 13, 14, going to one tournament in France in a place called Epony, where a lot of big clubs come to at that age. And we won that, so that was a big deal back then. In the youth cups, you always got beat on penalties every time, so I didn't manage to win any of the youth cups at Everton. Got a few trophies from when I was a kid in the park, my local team.
What about the one we won next to Alderley? It was like 7-6 or something like that. Jordan Barber scored.
Jordan Barber.
I think you may have scored the winner, you know.
What's the team called?
It's called a few. It's Kingsley, but
Kingsley.
I forget who the team was we were playing against, but it was a cup on a Saturday.
Yeah.
Remember that? I've still got photos of it.
Yeah, obviously, I used to be my coach. Didn't learn nothing from him. Absolutely clueless. Nah, he was a top guy. Looked after all his lads. We had a good team again, Kingsley. Frightening team. Really enjoyed every moment playing for Kingsley. So, any chance you get to play football or do anything you love, just grasp it with both hands and just do it to the best of your ability.
What would you do if it was in a final and events of penalties? Would you take one?
Yeah, always.
Do you look down to take it?
I'm alright, I think I am. I've missed a few, but me personally, I always want to grasp them opportunities because it's an opportunity to do well. Any opportunity you get to show yourself and prove yourself and do well, I think you should try and take it. So if penalties come out, I'll always put my hand up and say, yeah, I want it, even though I'm really pooing my pants, but I'll say, yeah, I want it.
Would you think
it
down the middle?
No. Power every time, make sure I score. Yeah. Why, you like to think then?
No.
one last question. I know you still got a lot of time in football, hopefully, but what are your plans after football? Do you get any thought?
Obviously, I'm still studying, do a degree part-time. So I think the further I get into that, I might pick something up from there and try and go into that after football.
Is that maths or science, you mean?
It's science, it's health sciences, so whatever field in there that physio. I like. Maybe physio, yeah. And at least I'll still be involved in football, but I think anything I do will still be football orientated, will still be around football.
Could you ever think of being a manager?
Nah.
No.
I think they get old quick, managers don't they? They're stressed all the time. I'm too cute for that. No,